testing. This is my final project. I'm just going to try and go down the list, what you listed out, and try and just explain what all I did. I mostly have it completed. I mostly have the song completed. I wanted to make sure that it took me quite a while to do it, because I basically made I chose hip-hop as the genre, but I had my bassoon. I played bassoon for, the melody of it. So I'm just going to play the completed song. It's an 8-bar intro, 8-bar hook, and then an 8-bar verse. So I'm just going to play it now. Sound output I have, the master tunes at 440 hertz, to keep it all in best in tune as it can. My audio card driver is the ASIO for all version 2, but when I had to do the bassoon solo, I had to switch it over to the ASIO FL Studio ASIO for some reason, because it wouldn't detect me playing a live sound through the other one for some reason, but I got that sorted out, as you could hear. Let's see here. Yeah, sample rate 48,000, buffer size 512 samples, input latency 16 ms, output latency 15 ms. And I don't use any kind of MIDI controller, so that doesn't really apply to me. I made a loop of 24 bars, and I can set it up as an example. Just do the first 8 as a loop, just so you have right, so you can see that I can do it. Good. So this is just the first 8 bars, just to show that I can make a loop. Created my instruments, I chose this dark piano and choir right here, as well as the Lord of the Strings. I guess I'll just have. I use that on the keyboard. Use the keyboard for that. Pretty much, I just had it playing basic root chords just to create some sound, just add sound to it. So I don't know if you can tell, but there are little breaks I put in just to kind of help refresh it. I put up some rest there in bar 8. But yeah, that's that one. The Lord of the Strings one. I pretty much did the same thing. I wanted to add a little bit of orchestral pitch to it. That's the same as mainly an orchestral instrument, so I just kind of wanted to add a little bit of that string, the orchestral string sound to it. Some effects that I imported from things that we got through class. Let's see here. Like this jungle kick. Which also helps with that hip hop genre. Yeah, I did that. I apologize for that, but there's a horrible lawnmower going outside my apartment right now. But I have some kits. Okay, so I used a quantize that I did, which was actually with the bassoon solo right here. I had troubles actually managing to line it up when I got to the verse section. I had a hard time trying to make the triplets in one of the measures line up right, so I had to use quantize for that. I'll use quantize for, I'll just play the bassoon solo. Then we'll add the little quantize the form of the two, so you can see that I can do it. Right-clicking, and then it has quantize on the right, so I'm going to do that. So the piece that I chopped and copied and pasted, I'm going to play what it started out as, and then I'll play for you what I changed it into. So this is what it started out as. No, it's not. It's not right. Sorry, I pressed the wrong button. I'm supposed to press the S and not the M. Sorry. That's what it originally sounded like. And then after I got through with it, I copied and pasted the same thing for the hook. I think I might have shaped one or two little notches here and there. And then for the verse, very similar. I just kind of changed the up so it didn't have, so it wasn't completely, it was more calm, I guess. Yeah, that's how I did that. Again, I used the razor tool to do that, and I would move things around. I'd use the erase tool when I wasn't doing anything. I needed to get rid of certain areas. Yeah, so I'm going to delete that original, since you've heard that. I showed you what was the intro, hook, and verse. You heard the first and second half of the verse. Well, you've heard this song, I think it was pretty. It was distinguishable enough to hear a sound effect that transitioned between the intro and the hook. The, I guess, sound effect 40 was what made it that. Made it do that? Or maybe it was. Yeah, I think. Sound effect 40 and sound effect 3 that you guys get, that I got from the class. This. I feel like those made a very good transition material. Clips for the bassoon thing. So I pressed shift and selected each bar, and I just right click, and then I hit join clips. Now it's all just one continuous thing. Instead of being divided out, I can probably do the same thing for some for that. That's also an example of me copying and pasting. I copied this exactly, the transition over to that. I didn't join the clips, so. Okay, so for the rack, I did check it. I'll play it again just so you can hear it, but I made sure there was no red coming out from the audio track area. There were a couple examples of where it was when I tried to fix it, like with the bassoon sample, the audio track one, there were a couple moments where it would get out into the red, so I lowered it down to level minus 478. As well as the Lord of the Strings one, I had to lower that down a bit, down to minus 423. I think everything. Oh, the sound effect one I had lowered to 440, and this one I'd lower down to minus 444, the vocal kick. Yeah, I'm gonna play it again so you can watch the distortion over that on the audio track. Recording the bassoon part, I noticed I did it in two different sessions. I did the hook one day, and I did the verse another day. And I noticed that there's a slight sound variation, I guess, between the two. And I'm guessing it's because I was in a different room for each day. It was very hard to find a room on campus where there's not a lot of sounds going on at the same time for the practice rooms. So I had to wait around, and it didn't always work out. So that's why there's a slight sound variation with the bassoon, I guess, for those two, for the hook and the inch, the hook and the verse sections. To make focus now on the mixer part. I haven't really touched the mixer yet. So, I was kind of hoping. Oh, here we go. A bit. I feel like it's pretty well blended. I'm not sure if I really need to get too involved with this process. let the bassoon part play a little bit and experiment with that. With the spectrum EQ. I wish we could keep turning that S off. Same thing with the strings, or are they, yeah, the strings, I'm going to go back to the rack and just make sure that there's nothing. Yeah, I think I resolved it okay, so I finished the beat. Kick a little bit for this. I think that that would be good. I think I've shown everything. If there's something that I forgot, let me know, and I'd be happy to go and try to find an example of what I did to show that for this. I'm going to play it one more time, just so you can kind of hear it. With the verse, one thing that I did in trying to distinguish the verse from the hook was just trying to put fewer instrumental fewer sounds into it compared to the hook, just to help differentiate it more. I think that sums it up. I hope you found the song enjoyable, and I hope you found it interesting hearing a bassoon doing a solo for a hip-hop genre. Thank you for an interesting semester. It's been very fun. I feel like I've learned a lot. Thank you. I'm gonna stop recording now, and I'll get that exported and uploaded to YouTube and send it all to you. Thanks again.